Morning, guys.
Morning.
How's everybody doing? I heard Rick kept y'all up last night, huh? Is that true?
2:30.
Yeah. He is a fire. I hear he's already up and hanging out and ready to go again, so. We'll probably
our biggest fan.
Our smallest fan.
I had to get dressed up today. My wife sent these clothes for me. I was like, here, look respectable. And we just my wife though, he was not there.
The best thing is cut to us in the car on the way here. He's like, which shirt? I don't know. And I'm like, go with that one. It's probably going to show less if you sweat. And then he's like, okay, but can you tie my tie? So there I am, like, tying his tie in the back seat. All right, there you go. I know. See, we look out for each other all the time.
I know. I actually, true story, I've never been to tie a tie. And so by now I refuse to tie a tie.
But he actually takes pride in it because.
I do, yeah.
It was.
What it was my. Yeah, my old man's going to watch this and he's going to remember. But when I was growing up and I was a kid, I'd always have to. My dad would come in his dress shirt, but it hasn't come. So he'd come in his dress shirt and his super starched neck and he'd tie his tie. And I was to go in and do this with the collar. And I always just seem to remember, like, that was such a routine for him for so long. And I kind of remember, and I don't know, I kind of remember the look on his face. And he probably just didn't want to go off to work and leave the kids. But it kind of didn't seem good. I just put a tie on, and kind of seemed like, all right. So he wore a tie every day.
Begrudgingly, obviously.
Yeah, right. Begrudgingly, I guess. And so I thought to myself, if I could go my whole life without ever having to tie a tie for somebody. Or no one can tell me what to do,
so now I can tie his ties for him.
So now Jensen does it for me, and like, does a little collar. And
but well, because my situation was the complete opposite. My father is an actor, so whenever he tied a tie, he was doing it for like an audition or a role or something. So it was like part of his costume, and that was intriguing to me. And I was so, Dad, you gonna teach me how to tie a tie? So he taught me at a very young age. I've been doing it ever since.
Yeah. So now
I think that and shaving were about the same time.
I never had that problem until like season 3 of Supernatural. It's like, what's going on, guys? My voice is changing.
And then the hair change. And here I stand before you today, change man.
How are you liking the show so far? We saw a lot of you guys in Chicago, but now we've had 2 new episodes and a little secret scene that. The stretching, did everybody see the scene? These guys are rock. He and Jim Beaver, they're the most difficult guys to break. You have to do just about everything. And still it doesn't work. So,
I don't know. Which one?
The
Broccoli
A's
are
pretty good.
Oh, yeah.
That was another Phil Segrisa special.
Well, you did it on your coverage. For those who haven't seen it, there's an outtake scene where Jared decided to really get into the exercise.
Richard Simmons style stretching.
And Phil liked it so much that he made us do it again on the reverse when we came around and shot, I think it was my coverage.
Yeah.
Second. And we... It was funny. So of course he's gonna take that and run with it.
Yeah. And some, I know I tweeted it and it got taken away because, and funny enough, is Phil called us. He's like, hey guys, I have to prove this with y'all guys. We're like, what? And so we watch it. We're like, yeah, it's funny, man. Send it. And so he's like, okay, cool. We got to go through legal and make sure it's all okay. And I mistook it as it was already approved. And so I kind of sent it out without being. What's that thing? Better to beg for forgiveness than ask for permission. So I found myself going, and they were like, listen, it's fine. It was going to get approved anyway. They just hadn't get signed off on it. But since you tweeted it, but now it's on YouTube. So I think the link on the tweeted it. I'm still learning. And I was so proud of myself yesterday. I was walking around Chicago and I saw that big Marilyn Monroe thing.
Yeah.
And so I took a picture of it and I was like, I'm gonna be funny. And so I wondered like, who knew Norma was so tall? But instead, I just found out this morning, I wrote, who Norma's so tall? I haven't yet mastered the proofreading thing yet.
Norma Jean Baker is tall. Who Norma is so tall?
Can't really unsend, or if you can't, can you unsend? Can I go back and change it? Come on, guys.
guys, help me out.
I don't have these problems, Jared. I don't have these problems.
That's true. What else? What happened Friday? I didn't see the episode. I was here with the band.
James and Kristen.
It was amazing.
That's right, yeah.
It was amazing.
Awesome.
It was.
They were rad, huh? You want them back.
Yeah.
It's so nice also, we've talked about this before, but to have people come in that are not just seasoned actors, but seasoned actors in the genre.
Oh, right. Yeah.
So, like Jewel and Charisma and James.
Right.
I mean, the list goes on and on, but they know how to suspend belief.
They get this genre. This is some, you know. It would be an adjustment for a comedy actor to come in and help you. Or any kind of, you know, it's just there's a very specific kind of cadence to what we do, and it's nice to have people come in who are just extremely comfortable with that style. It was cool. They were a lot of fun.
We had a few, especially season one, we had a few guest stars, I won't name, but they were like, I'm saying really weird things. And we're like, you read the episode, right? Like, you know what the show's about. Like, it sounds stupid. Like, how? Why would I even think this?
Who's Justin? Yeah, why are we talking about vampires?
Who is? I wouldn't believe you guys. And we're like, oh god. We're acting, like, but that's sort of the idea of the show. And this is well before the show had even aired. I think probably the first six or seven episodes, we had a few guest stars on for four episodes.
What was it? That old story. That Laurence Olivier said to Dustin Hoffman after Marathon Man or something like that. And he was like, method acting. And Olivier was like, you don't have to be the character. It's called acting. Try it. It's much easier. It's acting, my dear boy. Acting, my dear boy. Try it. It's much easier.
Well, now that we have y'all's wrap, oh, quick question. Is anybody here from St. Louis? Y'all can walk up.
You guys get
their answers. If an oxygen mask drops, you're not allowed to have one, nor are you.
And no one can help them with theirs.
I blew up the World Series to come see you.
You blew up the World Series?
I wish you had just blown up Albert Pujols. They really handed it to us last night. So.
I know. No, thank you. He really. Yeah, that was a difficult watch last night.
Yeah. All right.
Kick us when we're down.
You know, and here's a little fun fact for you. Today, a little FF. The Rangers are playing the Cardinals in Texas. And then right across the parking lot, the Cowboys will be playing the St. Louis Rams. I wonder what the odds of that are ever happening again. That's going to be a packed parking lot.
Yeah, that freeway is going to be.
That freeway is going to be, yeah. I'm actually headed there tonight.
Just don't drive the freeway.
But I'm not. After this, I'm going to Dallas.
Well, now that you'll have our attention, before we just jabber on, somebody yell something, right? Yes, perfect. Hey.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Wait, what? Wait.
I'm good. Yeah.
Thank you.
My question is...
Yes, I'm terrified.
We all are.
What?
And your dad would not be very friendly to a
retrospective
unless
it's
something
that
a
what?
What?
That's true. Jensen,
are you guys hearing any of this?
No.
Good.
She's saying that Hollywood does a lot of remakes, and obviously the Supernatural fandom wouldn't be happy if they tried to remake Supernatural, and this less they used our kids. And so my comment, of course, was, Jensen better hope he has a daughter.
Yeah, to man the character of Sam up.
Okay, What's that? We are. We're having a
boy. All personnel.
So was there a question in there, or was that just all hypothetical?
Don't do it, Bill. Wait till season four and play the angel. He gets like tons of time off. He's traveling all over the place.
Film closer to home.
Yeah. Or home. That'd be difficult. I guess what comes to mind is, don't worry, when you die, they'll bring you back. So don't be scared to hold that then. And the supernatural ointment that we use also works really well, so don't be scared of like demon scratches and missing limbs, just rub a little CW ointment on.
Unless you actually do stuff, like rip your hand open from the gun.
That's right. You just do the can, right? You shut up.
I just did the can. The first one was the cult I had in Frontierland. When I did the show down there, I actually had to fan the hammer, and that is not a very well-made gun, because we had it made for the show, so it's not like some highly engineered, it's just a piece of metal that they made to look like a gun, and it's really hard and difficult to use, and to actually fan that, I ripped open my palm on the first take, and just blood, and I just kind of held the flap of skin and clothes.
Something about flap of skin.
While I waited for Guy B to make the decision on whether or not we needed to go again, of course we did need to go again, and I'm like, wow, this is really going to hurt the second time. So they put like they slapped some moleskin, which is, you know, I don't know if you know what that is. Yeah. I don't really know what it is either. And I did it again, and of course it just cut deeper into my head. I have a nice little scar there for it, but. And then the other day we had to, what was the scene? It was, we were dealing with a monster that we thought was dead.
It was not.
So
like I said, don't worry,
it was a quick draw by all three, Bobby, Sam, and Dean, and it was a bit Reservoir Dog-esque, where we just put it down. Well, Jared and I both did a quick chamber of our pistols.
Sam and Dean did it.
Sam and Dean. And I didn't get it properly in the sight, the little metal sight that sticks up on the back of the gun, just ripped my callus right off of my finger. And it was instant blood all over your
face. And then Dr. Sexy.
And he wasn't part of that.
Then there was another, I keep on trying to get Jim, there was another, we then dissect the body. And we had this really icky, gooey, nasty stuff. And our characters are wearing gloves. But for his close-up, we didn't need gloves, and we didn't need to do anything. And so we're just mimicking like we're dissecting the body, as we do in Supernatural. And there's really nasty stuff that's been in there for the close-ups of it and stuff like that. And so I'm getting the tongs, and I'm touching him to his hand and stuff, because he's having to pretend to get stuff. I'm like, stuff all over his hand. He's like, you asshole! As soon as we cut, though, once again, I can't break the guy.
He's a rock.
He is. What is it? What did it do? Yes. Hi.
Hi. Amy told us yesterday to ask you about the awkward family trip scene with she and Matt in the front seat and you two in the back seat, and you talking to Genevieve on the phone about cleaning your back seat.
That was out of left field. That was one of those, like, look at my hand. Wah!
I knew that story.
Yes, I didn't mean her doing it, but does anybody have a small dog?
Yes.
Okay, does your small dog have issues with...
I think the answer to the question is that because we spent so much time on set, we have to deal with personal issues in front of everybody.
Well, you know when you see dogs?
This being one of them.
Yeah, this being one of them. When you see little dogs, and they're kind of like doing the butt scoot thing. And you're just supposed to...
We have a nurse in the house. she raises her hand. I'm certified.
I guess what that means is that you have to get them clean. But yeah, there are often conversations that he'll have, or that I'll have, or somebody will have, when you're kind of sitting there, and you overhear part of it, and you're like, okay, that could be mistaken.
Oh, absolutely.
Yes, but so she did, yeah, we have to take the dog.
Yeah. I'm sure other people have stories about conversations that we've had on set that are probably completely inappropriate for a working environment. So,
this is the most states. Y'all guys in the back, I know y'all had your hands up for a bit. What is that? Oh, yes. Yes. She was it. I know. Cliffy's going to grab it for
right behind you.
He's right behind you. Yes, I didn't think you'd actually bring it. Thank you very much. It's a guy we got dressed up. That's like the conversation, me and the tie is like Cliff and Pants.
It's true. It's like, it could be January in Vancouver on top of like Mount Seymour in, you know, 6 feet of snow. Cliff will be there in his shorts.
Yeah.
Shorts and a t-shirt.
And really pissed off he has to wear pants. There was a situation last year, actually. We went to a really nice restaurant here, just because we love food, and we went to a restaurant. And it was, I guess you had to have a coat, like a dress coat. And I didn't really have one. I was like, I don't wear a dress coat. It's like, why am I, what are you talking about? And so I wore a nice shirt or a sweater, whatever it was. And then we get there, and they're like, well, we can give you a jacket to borrow. And I was like, oh, okay, cool. I guess they have it. Seriously, I'm not even kidding. And so I was like, so they give me this jacket, and no kidding, I cannot, the jacket comes up about to here. Like, to roll up the sleeves, so I have this coat on that looks like it's made for kind of a hefty older gentleman, so it's really long, really wide, the arms are here. I guess I just, what do I do, roll them up to my elbow? Like, that's going to look awkward, like, here I'm in a suit coat with a jacket rolled up to my elbow, and they're like, okay, we're going to take your seats. And I was like, wait, why doesn't Cliff have to wear a jacket? They go, well, we don't have any in a size. And I go, you don't have any in my size either. And so then they're like, well, just, and so we follow them, and literally we walk 30 feet to a table, and I just take the jacket off. I go, well, that was kind of... So we don't have one in the
south. Apparently that's not the thing here. Like, there was a restaurant that we were going to go to Friday night, and I canceled because it was a jacket required. And I'm like, I ain't going through that again. I didn't bring a blazer. So, yeah, I don't know. In LA, it's a little, like, you can go to the fancy, you can go to Spago in jeans and flip-flops if you want. They're like, we don't care.
Yeah.
You're paying the money, we'll give you the food.
Sure. Doesn't make your enjoyment of food any better. I don't know, anyways, I'm sorry, somebody here has a motto about having to wear jackets. I didn't mean
it. I mean, yeah, and I'm, you know, the restaurants are great, yeah. Just make sure you wear jackets.
I totally ignored you, sorry.
Okay. I just wanted to say happy Polish
Harry
as much
as
to
you. Jawohl. Thank you.
And then, I got next.
You got next?
Yeah, I totally got
a high bottom. Which means we'll probably do this. Yeah.
Can you tell me
your baby's contact? As soon as I find out in March, I'll tell you. Yeah. I really have no idea.
The store.
We've all seen Dumbo. Store comes and their ears flop and they get out, they clean their butts and... I'll tell you in March after I find out. Whatever, in January, whatever.
Hey, he's still trying to figure that out.
When I wake up.
Wait, you're what? Now. You're doing what? We're having a.
How does that work?
How did that happen?
And then I was gonna. When finally, I had a lot of fun getting the information out. I wanted everybody to know first who was watching me as opposed to hearing somewhere else. And I was telling Jen that I was gonna make a joke of it. I was like, we can't take ourselves too seriously. I was like, I'm gonna tweet something like, I'm having a kid. According to Jen, it's 25% chance that it's mine. She was like, it's funny, but tell your friends, but don't tweet it, because, like, my mom reads your tweets, your mom. like, oh yeah, okay, good idea. So we had to have fun another way. But I was like, who normal was so tall? So I'm still getting the hang of it, what I can say, what I can't. And then Misha crosses all boundaries, and so I'm like, oh, I guess I can say whatever.
Did Misha tell you about West's little accident in my backyard?
No.
I'll let him tell you. Not my story to tell. I just it's nothing big. It's just a little funny story.
Misha,
he's got plenty of funny stories. I'm sure he'll use this one eventually. Yeah, there we go. You have a question here.
Also, somebody did in Twitter ask him about the story of West in my backyard too. I think I told you. Ask him about how West enjoys Jensen and Jared's backyards.
Yes. Hi. Yep, there's your nurse right there.
I'm a practitioner. There's a difference.
Got
it. I have a question. I thought you guys had medics or whatever on set, or not medics, but people in physician or whatever. So why did they just fix it for
He treated it. Mike? We have first aid on set.
Yeah, we have first aid. We have our craft service is also a registered nurse in DC, so. It's true. He is.
It's true.
Yeah, we don't utilize him in Jared's problems, but.
In the States, you have to have two different. You have to have first aid and craft service in Canada.
In Canada.
Where all the Canadians live. Anyways, in Canada.
It's one of the
same. It's one union. It's called first aid craft service.
Okay.
So.
Nurse
practitioner.
So I see.
It's usually
nurse practitioner.
I see. We don't have a physician on set unless it's an emergency.
But we do have, we'll have technical advisors and stuff for like the medical scenes who will, you know, they'll hook everybody's IV up and make sure all the monitors are running properly and stuff when we have hospital scenes. But as far as like taking care of like the health of the actors and stuff or the crew, we have one guy, he's got, you know, a full medical bag. Whenever we have big stunts, he comes in with his, you know,
his first aid training.
Gauze and first aid and stuff. I would imagine,
The union rules, they have to do both. Then you can't have, so you have no choice with your first aid craft service.
He's actually a trauma paramedic.
Right.
Oh, yay. Yeah.
Cliff, you had your chance.
And he's very good. He's
rad.
Yeah.
We'll have, Right. We also have a doctor named Dr. Lim who does a lot of film sets, and he's a physician, so he'll come by.
Yeah, he'll come by. If it's something that needs medical attention, we'll have a guy come to the set.
Actually, funny enough, one time he came by because I had a massive zit. Honest to God, I had a massive zit that was literally shattering my... This is kind of embarrassing, but I'm...
Too late now.
Ask Misha to tell you after the Yes.
Shot of cortisone.
It was causing a shadow on my face.
I thought he was getting Botox, and I walked.
And then, we went to pop it, and it wouldn't pop. It was like a little nodule. Flap of skin.
Again, things that we deal with because we spend way.
See, that's the point. We just get used to like you spend 14 hours or more a day with somebody. You're like, I don't have time to wait to say this. I'm just gonna say it now.
So are you scooting your forehead?
There's no forehead scooting.
I scoot the other way.
On behalf of Bart Boyce, I'm supposed to ask you about the metronome.
Yes.
Guy B.
I don't know. That's probably best left for the gag reel.
Oh, you know what? You are going to see on the gag reel.
I'm sure
it
will be there.
It's something that can't be explained. It's kind of a physical explanation.
It is.
That's right.
There was a question over here. Yes, hi.
Me?
Yeah.
Jensen, are you and Daniel going to the Breeders' Club again this year?
Don't plan on it.
Did you not enjoy yourself?
We did. It's just sometimes it's kind of one of those things where we're available and it's happening and we win. But it's not something we like, you know.
You're not a horse racing fan?
Well, yeah. I mean, I like it, but it's not. I'm not a big gambler. So I go to just kind of enjoy the races. But that was something that her agent was actually going and had like a box and stuff and was like, hey, you guys ought to come. And we're like, yeah, we're available, let's go. So it was kind of one of those things.
I thought you were going to ask a much more exciting question. When I heard breeder, I thought I was like, man, she's bold. So are you and Daniil going to breed? Jensen, what about Daniil? Are you going to breed her? That's the question I had. Have you ever read, there are funny things you can look online where it's like, it's mind games. So it'll be a sentence and it'll say, isn't it funny when you realize that you didn't read the word that you were supposed to before the sentence, and then you go back and you actually read it slowly, and the wording is completely different, like they switch letters around, so your brain hears what it wants to hear. That's also strange, but... Anyways, anybody else? Sorry. Way in the back.
Yeah, they were pretty obviously fake, weren't they? And that they were kind of contained right into my fache. Yes, I read that and I was like, but.
What? The bees in the face was.
The bees in the face on the left.
Was he excited that they were?
Was I excited
animated?
That they were fake? That they were CG? And obviously, yes, I was very happy that they had actual bees swarming around my face.
The flip side, it's really. I mean, like you can do a lot of acting stuff, and great actor or not, it's really difficult to act like there are bees in your face. I mean, you're like. It just looks weird.
Did you see it?
It looks good. I mean, I saw the very.
They actually had to do everyone spit one out.
That's what I was going to say. I was like, oh, that's cool. Clippy and I saw it up in Adams one, actually, before we came back here. Just the end of it. But yeah, I saw that. Because he was just. So it's difficult. Luckily, he did something. Because otherwise, he'd just stand there going.
Yeah. But yes, after season one. Bugs, when we did actually have 60,000 bees with stingers in a room that was much about the size of the stage, I was.
Did you stung in the side?
I got stung just in the lower back and on the thigh. Yeah.
That's not the butt.
Yeah.
Yep, got it. All right.
That was one of my most like. I wish I had a camera. When they told us, they were like, okay, look, they're docile bees. Yeah. They're not going to sting you unless you're aggressive towards them. So as long as you're
drone bees,
they're drone bees. They'll be fine. They won't harm you. And then you and I kind of looked at each other like, when they say action,
we're swinging
getting to freak out. And the bee wrangler just looked at us and goes, oh.
And
turned and walked away. We're like, what?
Also, everything's so perfect and fine. No, they're drone bees. They don't get agitated. But then you do take one, they release.
I've got a flamethrower that I'm actually killing these bees with.
And they're vacuuming the bees to put them back into the place before they release them again. So it's like a really light vacuum. But they're getting pissed off. And I was flying around, I got vacuuming, and then I'm flying around again. I was swatting at them. And finally, the guy's like, they're starting to get a little upset. I'm like, so are you
really?
He's an animal wrangler, like God love him, but he's not an actor. He's like, well guys, just guide them away. Like, just do this. He's like, if there's one of your arms, just simply guide it. Guide the bees?
Oh, guide you.
Like Sam and Dean.
But of course, just when Jared and I were like, wait a minute, we're really getting screwed here. I protest. Kim Manders goes, all right, somebody grab me an apple box, and walks into the set where everybody else has full bee outfits on except for us. He walks in shorts and a t-shirt, sits down with a handheld monitor in the middle of the bees, and he's like, all right, if you're going to go through it, I'm going to go through it. Let's roll camera. And then both Jared and I were like, well, now we don't have anything to say.
Everybody else is in the suits, like at the end of E.T., where like you barely see it, like, the abyss. Are you scuba diving or are you like rolling camera? Massive wetsuits.
All right, they're pulling us off here, guys. Thank you so much. It's
now. I have a quick question.
How many people new to convention or to this convention do we have here? That's very cool. It's always nice to see new faces.
And y'all didn't tell me before I started doing the butt thing that we have rookies.
All right, well, I hope you enjoy the weekend, and we've got a little bit more for you, so we'll see you a bit later. Thank you.
See you later.